Hey guys, I'm gonna walk you through three-point lighting. This is kind of the first thing you learn day one of film school and production class. So I've got three lights for this setup right here. I've got a key light, a fill light, and a hair light. Really quickly, I'm gonna show you what these do by turning them off. So let's just keep the key light on. So the key light is the most important light. It kind of sets the scene. It gets the cast the most light. I'm using 85 watt bulbs, and there's four of them. So you can do the math of how much watt is just coming out of there. I'm not a math major, I'm a film guy. So key light, most important light. And by the way, this is not for scenes. I'm not telling you how to light an environment or a house or a room. That is totally different lighting techniques. We're covering 3-point, which is mostly for subjects. So animals, people, or products is gonna use the 3-point. So that's the key. Then we've got the fill. I'm gonna just keep the fill on and turn off the key. And that's with the fill. So this is actually a little bit diffuse. It's not as bright as the key light. I've only got 285 watt bulbs on there plus the diffusion. The diffusion is a little balanced whiteboard, and then it's held up by a C-stand. So kind of standard film gear. And then I wanna show you what it looks like just with the hair light. And the hair light is actually what I think kind of makes that Hollywood movie look to your film. So instead of just having the key and the fill all on you and it's all coming from the front, you've got the hair light, which is giving you this glow, kind of popping you from the background. And I think that separating you from the background is such a more professional look that you kind of can add to your film. I've got it on a regular stand here, you can see, so we framed it out of the shot. But actually, one thing I would do if I was really filming this for myself, I would pan the camera a little bit more. The cool tip is that if you have a light source and it's coming from an angle where your light was also casting, it's gonna make it seem to the audience that this light is coming from the natural light. And so anytime you can do that in a scene, it really helps sell light sources. It's not just like, oh, I know they have this light over here. They put their key light right there because there's a giant, you know, block of light and then shadows. Also, like if you're using a lamp, for example, you could put a light near that lamp and kind of cast the light down as if that lamp is actually working. That's what they do in Hollywood all the time. They want to make it seem like it's practically in the set. So I'm going to crank on all the lights now. Let's go ahead and turn them all on. Another important thing about all this lighting setup is that these are natural daylight temperatures. If you're gonna do something like tungsten and I lit this right now, it would look kind of funky because you'd see the outside is daylight, just like these are, coming in the windows, and we'd have this clash of color, warm and cold color temperature. So be kind of mindful when you're shooting to have color temperatures either planned, or like if you want a warm and a cold 2-in-1 shot, that's great. A lot of Hollywood movies do that to emphasize different things about the characters or the story. But in this case, you know, usually all our videos are shot with this light setup here and this natural temperature. The last thing about lights is, of course, the further you move them away, the dimmer they get. If you don't have a dimmer or a dim box, something you can actually turn down the light brightness, you can also use diffusion. So that's how to do the 3-point lighting system pretty quickly. Just remember the key light, the main one, the fill, kind of diffuse and coming in here on the side, and then the hair light on the back, making this nice little light shimmer. Okay, so quick outside tip for lighting an interview really fast. Nothing even crazy, it just requires a C-stand, you know, your chair for your interviewer, and then here, one of these bounce boards. So just pops open like that, we open up the C-stand. So I'm putting this up here, resting it on top of here. We're popping this up. And we're just blocking where the chair is right there. So that is probably a good place for this. And in Hollywood, on a union set, you know, you're gonna need to put a sandbag on there so this doesn't tip over and knock me on the head. But I'm gonna be okay. I'm not gonna sue anybody if it falls on myself. So that's how I would light an outside interview real quickly in 30 seconds. And then the key is just making sure your background is as dark, not overexposed, as your subject here. Hey, what's up guys? We're gonna be talking about this gorgeous time of the day, which is called the golden hour. And the reason this is called the golden hour is because it gives you this beautiful light about an hour and a half before the sun goes down. And so we like to take advantage of this in our videos. You know, when you see a good wedding video, usually they're towards that hour, which is great, and you're shooting that and it looks beautiful. We're doing this with Jedi Kittens right now. So, of course, when you have only an hour to film, you've got to usually spread that shoot over a couple days. So that's the difficult part about the golden hour. Plus you're trying to beat finishing your shoot before the sun actually goes down. If you don't get all your shots, again, you're gonna have to come back. So there's pros and cons to the golden hour. Con being there's not a lot of time to shoot, but when you get it, it's really gorgeous. So think about shooting your film, if it really helps, all in the golden hour.